So y'all ever do a deadlift-based workout afterwards, you're just too exhausted to do much else because you're exhausted on deadlifts? Well, deadlifts are not only the king of all back exercises, they're basically the king of all exercises. Working every part of your body and straining and stressing and building your core like nothing else. In fact, I call it the most rehabilitative exercise because it makes everything feel better, everything work better, everything fire. I've worked up in weight. One plate, two plate, three plate, four plate. This is my fifth plate. I'm going to try to go up to six. So what we're going to do here, for our heavy sets, I like to stress overload and put as much posterior chain load as possible. So 2 to 8 reps is normally what I go for, and I pyramid down in reps as I go up in weight. So if I start at 8 reps, I'll end up at 2. So for this set, this is could be my maximal set. It depends how I feel today. But we're gonna do deadlifts as our foundation. From there, we're gonna do a movement to hit our lats, which would be a pull down movement, wide grip or close grip, and then we're gonna do a row. It's a simple 3 exercises you can add to that, but those are the core of what you need to build a big, amazing Barndoor back. So, we're gonna get into it. This isn't a form video, but just real quick on this, when you go up on the deadlift, breathe in, stick your stomach out, that creates an internal belt. The belt helps push pressure out on it, which makes for greater intra-abdominal pressure, preventing any kind of injury. You're gonna come down, you're gonna engage your hamstrings. I don't want you in a squat form, I want you engaging your hamstrings. Scapula retracting, which means squeezing your shoulder blades together, and then blast up. So here we go. I use straps, because I don't care. Get your stance. An imaginary object 10 feet in front of you on the floor that gives you a neutral spot.
Why don't they understand now? Why don't they get me? I guess I got a plan now. There's nothing that can heal me. Feel like I'm treading water. No one's gonna save me. I'm in the middle of the ocean. I won't let it take me. There's some fucked up things I'm thinking. I can't get outside my head. Locked out so many goddamn people. Rather stay up on the fence. When it comes to helping others, they just focus on their bread. Overlooking what they have, inconsiderate at best. Yeah, now I'm going in cause I'm pissed off. Know what I feel that I'ma go ahead and get lost in my own damn head. My anxiety gon' rip on all my thoughts till I admit that I came here to be my own boss. Oh.
The heavy stuff is done, and boy was it heavy. After that, you're thoroughly exhausted. Now, lat pull downs are one option, okay? But if you're strong enough, a lot of you heavier guys can't do that many pull-ups. If you can do over 6 reps of pull-ups, I highly recommend pull-ups because you'll put your body in its natural position. You're not doing anything funny, you can't really lean back and work too much back instead of lats. Pull-ups are your body's way of naturally checking yourself before wrecking yourself. So, grab it, it's gonna be a wide grip. You're gonna need wide grip for this. Kick this bench out of the way, like that. Come in, up, squeeze. So there, 3 to 4 sets of 6 whatever reps. I like to keep it at 15 reps. If you can do more than that, put a weight belt on, put some dumbbells between your legs to make sure you get that resistance where you can only get 6 to 15 reps. So, we've done the bread and butter. The deadlift works every part of your body. We've done the pull down / pull up, which works more of your lats. Now we're gonna bring it all together by working your back. Now, these are the core 3. If this isn't enough for you, if for some reason you did not feel like you'd go home after deadlifts, by all means, add to this, but these are 3 movements. Now, you don't need to do this. A cable row, anything of this nature. The reason I love this row is because, one, it's my favorite row. That's why we got it in my gym here in Tiger Fitness headquarters in Loveland, Ohio. Which, by the way, shoot me an email, Marc at Tiger Fitness. You can train here for free whenever you want, as long as we're here to let you in. 24-hour access, you're gonna have to pay. But anyway, the beauty of this is you don't have to, you've exhausted your core and everything doing a deadlift. So by doing this, you're literally able to just target your muscle and overload it. We're gonna do two arms at one time, unilateral. You can cheat more. We don't wanna cheat, we just wanna squeeze and overload. Take it, keep your chest against the pad. You'll see people doing this, don't do that. Come in, boom, squeeze. Scapula together, scapula retraction, boom. All right, so check it out. So, that's the workout. This is the base. Can you add more? Yes. Can you add biceps in this? Yes. Can you add abs? Yes. But you definitely must do a deadlift, a pull-up motion, and a row. And that is how you build a big-ass back. I'm Marc Lobliner, tigerfitness.com. The rep ranges, work up in deadlifts. Ranges, 2 to 8 reps on the deadlift. As high as you can go, around 2 reps for your maximal set, which will definitely overload your posterior chain. Next, 3 to 4 sets, 8 to 12 reps on a pull down or a pull up. If you can only do 6, do 6. If you only do 2, do 2. But if you can do pull ups, do them. If you can't, do pull downs. Rows, 3 to 4 sets, 6 to 12 reps. That's your base. Get it done. That's not a game.